Auston Matthews, when it comes to the grand scheme of things, he makes his team so much better because you now have to focus on another superstar in the lineup, another point per game guy who can score on the power play, score 5-on-5, and can create.
One touch is all it requires, and on that touch, he can beat any goalie from anywhere.
For Matthews, with room, walks in and fires, scores! Auston Matthews, power play goal, that's 2-0 Toronto!
Hey everyone, welcome to On the Fly. I'm Erica Wachter. Happy to be back here with you, and happy to report that Auston Matthews is back to game action. He returned to the Leafs lineup Wednesday for the first time since January 25th. The reigning Hart Trophy winner missed 5 games with a sprained knee, and over that stretch, the Leafs went 2-3-0 with a pair of losses to non-playoff teams. So it is safe to say Toronto could use a boost from the two-time Rocket Richard winner. Now, not surprisingly, despite the 3 weeks between games played, the 25-year-old who had 8 goals in his 11 games prior to that injury, well, he picked up right where he left off. Let's head to the six for the highlights against the Hawks.
And Auston Matthews back after missing 5 with a knee sprain. The Leafs 2-3 without their top gun. And Toronto fans can window shop tonight with Patrick Kane reportedly available before the trade deadlines.
Puck is down underway here in Toronto, and it's William Nylander right to the net, and he scores! 9 seconds! What a start for the Toronto Maple Leafs.
D to D up the middle, a classic place, in all alone, and how about the patience to the outside as Nylander bounces it off the skate of Mrazek.
What a start for the Leafs.
Back, gave it away. Here's a chance, and it's in, and the game is tied. 1:02 in. Oh, Sam Lafferty gets it back.
Is it going to be one of those nights?
A flip pass that causes a little bit of trouble here, but Yarncroke just trying to control it, didn't see that Lafferty had inside position on Liljegren, and it said at one end, good patience. How about that? Just holding on to it long enough as Samsonov came out quickly, and there's the response. In 1:02, Lafferty ties this game up.
Hired right back by Tavares. Shot scores! In off Connor Murphy. And that's the first goal at home for Rasmus Sandin.
And for Sandin, just a little bit of confidence that you need. He does a good job of being aggressive. You win the draw, and look at Murphy, kind of had nobody for a second. He ends up in no man's land. The forward is late getting Sandin, and just another good example of to throw the puck to the net. What a good aggressive play there by Sandin to jump down and get it towards the net.
Here's Nylander, across for Matthews. His shot, he scores! Auston Matthews in his first game back makes it 3-1 Toronto here in the first.
Nylander actually semi-stopped on the play.
Nylander is able to keep it in there. A little bit of a hesitation. Domi's calling him offside instead of getting that passing lane. And how about that for Matthews? The stop, the quick move, the body. And that's when he's at his best. That's when you know you're feeling healthy, your mind's in shape. That's a Matthews goal we've seen numerous times.
Domi works in, and Kurashev scores. And it's a one-goal game. And a trend of Leafs second period play has started again.
Domi, who's going to have the puck here, and when you keep your eye on Domi here, he's going to buy some time and buy some time. He's waiting and waiting and waiting, but that allows Kurashev with that good wrister to fire that in past the glove side.
There's Kerfoot, and Doug scores! John Tavares from Kerfoot, and they restore the 2-goal lead.
And this is just a hard work play by Kerfoot, a no-look pass, and a frustration play there. Mrazek gets caught in between. Do I go with my glove? Do I go with my stick? He gets neither. Great pass by Kerfoot, good quick shot by Tavares, and there's your 2-goal lead back.
On high, a shot from Timmins, and he scores! Connor Timmins lets it fly from long range.
This blast, he got all of it. I didn't believe from my vantage point it hit anything on the way in. Jones is in front. It's almost a double eye formation of screens. This shot had absolute eyes there to go on the stick side. And a very difficult one for the goaltender to see.
5 seconds after this power play ended, they're now shorthanded. 2-on-1 shorthanded. Yarncroke has Kerfoot. Yarncroke shots down off the shoulder of Mrazek. And Kerfoot couldn't knock it out of the air.
Kept in by Sandin. Engvall in front. Oh, what a stop. Peter Mrazek. Flashing weather against Cali Yarncroke.
Right here at Scotiabank Arena, appreciative of the show. put on by the Maple Leafs tonight. Domi runs out of time. The Maple Leafs can celebrate a 5-2 win over the Chicago Blackhawks in the return of the lineup for Austin Matthews.
Yes, the Maple Leafs come away with the dub over the Blackhawks 5-2 in Austin Matthews' return. Matthews ended the night with a goal and an assist for his 150th career multi-point game. And Mitch Marner, he extends his point streak to 7 games with an assist. He's got 7 helpers in that span. Now let's hear from Matthews on his first game back in the lineup.
Not too bad. I think, obviously the adrenaline kicks in and stuff. And I think my energy faded a little bit throughout the game, but I think that's kind of to be expected. But for the most part, I felt pretty good. We played together quite a bit, so I think it's... nothing really changes. I mean, we still want to be hard on pucks and compete and move off the puck for each other because, between Mitchie and Willie, they're both so good with the puck, skate extremely well, and obviously pass it extremely well. So, I think that mindset never really changes, and just trying to get open and use each other out there. I thought we did a pretty good job of that for the most part tonight.
Well, all the buzz this season has surrounded Austin Matthews and Mitch Marner. But what about Willie Nylander? He's flown under the radar by not only leading the Leafs in goals with 30, but also in three-point games this season. And he doesn't just lead, he's doubled up Matthews and John Tavares. I say it's time we start giving Nylander the love that he deserves. Now let's head to Arizona, where the Coyotes faced off against the Lightning.
At Mullet Arena, where it is Star Wars night.
Fans need to see a game here before this place goes away. The game hasn't even started yet, and it's going to be awesome.
Lightning power play didn't do so hot last night. And now Stamkos is sliding to make the save. Here's Connor Ingram. Taken away. Keller's got it to the front. Oh, and he had Hayden, but they can't hook up. And Hayden unable to get a shot off on Elliott. He had the shot. I would have liked to see him fire that puck. Point with a shot and a rebound as well. Covered up by Connor Ingram. And he's can't get it out. Good keep Kucherov for Stamkos to the front. Point! Oh, and he can't. Kind of rolled off his stick.
Point trying to outweight the netminder on that chance. Shots were 21-7.
Shot by Fleury is blocked in front. Fleury again gets a shot off the end boards. Oh, what a stop. It's right on the goal line. And they keep it out. Oh, the rebound was trickling.
That was Soderstrom, I think, with a great stick in front of Connor Ingram. An
0-for-2, the Lightning, with those 11 shots.
Barrett Hayden in, stopped by Elliott. Big save there.
Guys that don't kill penalties. Brought in by Keller. Now Keller, sharp angle shot, and Elliott fought it off.
Close, squeezes past Kucherov, cuts in, back end, saved by Elliott. A brilliant glove stop.
It's brought along. Here's another chance. Point Sorelli, stopped again by Connor Ingram.
This is ridiculous. What a performance.
Here's a chance in front and a save made by Elliott.
Brian Elliott's done a heck of a job in this game of keeping his head in it.
Gets away from Hayden, and now Clayton Keller's going to skate into this one. Keller with Hayden, waits, shoots, stopped by Elliott. On the top goal scorer the Coyotes have.
That's the Coyotes. Outshot 39-16. I'll tell you what, you know what's going to happen in this one. You can feel it.
Yusso Valimaki and Keller is the point man on this power play.
Out of position. Nothing happening towards the net. There's one. Loose puck. They bang away. Elliott's down. And finally, he finds it. Mad scramble around that Lightning man, and Elliott has got it.
And we are headed to overtime.
What an OT this is going to be.
Hagel with a burst of speed. Hagel, a little drop. Stamkos. He can't put it home. Oh, what a stop. Connor Ingram again.
Ridiculous. Only 505 goals
for Kucherov. To Nemestikov. Oh, and another save. Connor Ingram again. Out high, Hedman. Hedman to the front. And it's underneath and out of play. He gets a standing O at that end. With just 10.6 remaining in overtime. They're going to get a look. Kucherov takes it towards the front. He shoots off the pipe. Oh, my. All the way back. Bjugstad, one final shot. It's gloved by Elliott. And why not? Let's just go to the shootout. And Clayton Keller comes in. On Elliott to the front. He scores. Oh, is that greasy?
Dirty.
Nikita Kucherov, third shooter for the Lightning. He's in. It stopped. Bobby got it in. Coyotes win.
What a stop by Connor Ingram. Are you kidding?
quite the game in the desert, and it's the Coyotes who get the 1-0 shootout win and snap Tampa's 3-game win streak. Connor Ingram was the star as he stops all shots faced and earns a shutout in this one. Arizona has now won 2 straight for the first time since the end of December. And what a way to earn your first career shutout. Connor Ingram stopped all 47 shots against the Lightning in regulation and overtime to cement himself in club history. He now has the second most saves in a shutout in Coyotes franchise history. All right, making your NHL debut against the juggernaut Rangers would make you nervous, right? Well, I guess if you can juggle as well as Canucks rookie Artur Sylovs, you're cool as a cucumber. We'll check out the highlights from this game next.
He's checked on the play and he scores! As he continues his hot scoring!
Andre after it.
Trade. The Rangers had a need, and they certainly fill it with a guy like Vladdy Tarasenko.
I love it.
It's Tarasenko from Panarin. It's magic. Whoa, here's Panarin. He scores again. It's a 4-goal night.
Wow, wow.
It's an easy game, right?
This will be the Rangers' 5th win in a row.
Oh, man, the Rangers have been on a heater, and you never walk away from a heater. The Blue Shirts have an NHL best 12-2-2 record since January 1st, and they don't seem to be cooling off anytime soon, especially when they're adding talent like Vladimir Tarasenko. And you know who's the most happy about adding Vladdy? Well, his buddy Artemi Panarin, of course, who scored 4 goals and 2 assists since the Rangers made that big trade. Can we call them the early winners of the trade deadline? I think so, but right now the Rangers would settle for being a winner in Vancouver on Wednesday.
21-year-old Artur Sylovs makes his NHL debut after getting a call-up from Abbotsford following the reassignment of Spencer Martin. In tight, Sylovs in trouble. There's a high hit. Truba stepped up on Joshua, who's now challenging Jacob Truba. They go their separate ways.
Boy, that's one thing. When you're playing against Jacob Truba, you better keep your head up. That was Dakota Joshua. Felt that one.
Joshua now into the drop pass. Quinn Hughes with a shot stopped by Shesterkin. Puck loose. Oman jamming away. Now Joshua scores. That's one way to answer a big hit. Dakota Joshua opens the scoring. 4:52 into the first period.
A greasy goal. That's what you want. Tip. Shesterkin can't handle it.
Fox leading Zibanejad with room. He moves in. He shoots. He scores. Mika Zibanejad. Another beauty, and he ties the game with a goal in his 5th consecutive game.
When you're a young goalie playing your first game against high-end players, they'll give you that little fake, and a lot of times they'll bite.
And Jimmy Vesey fans it open, and he scores! It's Artemi Panarin! Outstanding play by that line! And a great setup from Vesey to Panarin, and Artemi Panarin continues red hot.
Passes to Hughes, back to Pettersson. Miller at the side, 40 seconds to go on the power play. Miller, one-timer, scores! Shesterkin didn't have his goal stick. I don't know if that's one of the reasons why the puck found its way in, but JT Miller's tied the game at 2.
The Rangers and Vancouver Canucks have taken turns leading. Trocheck puts in with a shot wide.
Oh, boy. What a move he put on Shen.
Oh, and they score. That puck got through the rookie, Sylovs. And the Rangers have the lead for the second time. It's 3-2. It looks like the new Ranger, Nico Mikola. And the Rangers take over. Tarasenko, Zibanejad, Kreider, score! Oh, is that a beauty? That's just how you draw it up. That was perfect passing and a great finish. And the Rangers lead 4-2.
Beautiful passing and that little freeze and the perfect little pass over to the other side.
Ryan Lindgren gets the loose puck. Hit his own teammate with the clearing attempt. Tries. He's making it. Nice move. Gets right in. Hit the other side of the bar, but they score. The rebound. the dipsy doodle from Kuzmenko and the rebound backhand of Ry Garland, and it's 4-3.
Tipped away. Shot by Miller, he scores! Great shot by Keandre Miller! And the Rangers regain the two-goal lead. It's 5-3.
Keandre Miller with the wrist shot beats Seelovs. Goes right over the glove.
Here's Kuzmenko right up the gut. Picked his spot and snapped it. And it's a 5-4 game.
The defense is pushed back by Elias Pettersson. And there's the shot. You can see the respect that the defense have for Pettersson. And that shot goes right underneath the glove.
Canucks pull the goalie.
Into the Rangers zone.
Shoot.
To Sorokin. And it was partially blocked. He was shooting for the empty net. Here's Panarin. He missed. Zibanejad scores. Mika Zibanejad with an empty net goal. Shesterkin attempt.
No, he hit Kuzmenko with it. He couldn't get it up high enough. Kind of went off the end of his stick.
The Rangers' NHL best win streak lives on as they defeat the Canucks 6-4 on Wednesday. Artemi Panarin finds the back of the net twice, giving him 6 goals in the last 2 games. Mika Zibanejad also extends his goal streak to 5 straight games for the 4th time in his career. Here's Zibanejad on the Rangers' locked-in offense.
We keep talking about doing the right things, and we know we can score, and just gotta make sure we make the right decisions, that we don't try to, you know, sacrifice the defensive part or put ourselves in a bad spot that way. But I thought we did a good job tonight and got the 2 points.
Just try to pump faking and see what he gives me, and done that a couple of times before. So I don't know if he bit on the pump fake. I just saw opening between his legs there and try to put a 5-1 and win it.
So the Rangers win their 6th in a row, all while scoring over 5 goals per game. Their special teams have been tremendous as well. The power play has been scoring at over 30%, and their penalty kill has allowed just 3 goals in those 6 games. Let's head to Anaheim now as the Ducks face the Sabres.
Well, certainly the Anaheim Ducks have their hands full taking on a Sabres team that is a high-powered offense.
You're in a race for a playoff spot. There's pressure because you should beat the Anaheim Ducks. You got to score. You got to produce.
They need the win, that's for sure.
And a penalty coming up to the Ducks.
Sabres are 6 for their last 44 on the power play.
And the Ducks now 17 of their last 18 on the penalty kill spanning the last 6 games.
And try to get Anaheim early here at this hockey game. You've got to get this early goal to try to make them force them to start playing from behind.
That one slides in the back of the net as the Sabres try to work it out front from below the goal line. Jost will get credit for it, and it's a 1-0 Buffalo lead here in the opening period.
Dostal is just not very comfortable in this net.
So far, the book on him's been pretty good. Sabres maybe having him rattled early. Need to get to him. Skinner up top for Dahlin. Thompson scores! Tage Thompson unleashes the TNT from his house there at the left circle, and the Sabres take a 2-0 lead. 98.6 miles per hour.
So sitting back here in the Sabres so far tonight, they're going at them.
Sabres with a 2-0 lead and right back into the Anaheim zone.
They do have the offensive players, and you got a team like this that's very, I don't say bad or have a lot of trouble in their own zone. They're a minus 90 in goal differential on the season. You want to try to take advantage of that.
Anaheim able to change and goes right back to work trying to dominate in the Buffalo zone. Room for Trevor Zegras. Nice pass across. Shattenkirk scores! First of the year for Kevin Shattenkirk, and the Ducks are on the board.
Well, this is a much different looking period so far, isn't it?
That changes the complexion of this one. 7 minutes into the second period, now a one-shot hockey game.
And Fowler scores! Great traffic in front. Grant was blocking out the sun. It's a brand new hockey game.
Just like that. After being fairly well dominated in the opening period, the Ducks have drawn even.
Anaheim all of a sudden is a lot more wins in terms of those puck battles.
Shattenkirk right down Main Street. Comer leaves it laying around and they score. Cam Fowler's second of the game. And there it is, Eric Comrie leaving some loose change. And the Ducks have the lead.
Sabres trying to change that. Quinn Goodhart battle, sends it in front, scores! Peyton Krebs, just like that, ties the game right back up at 3. All of a sudden, the Sabres with that 3-3 goal, starting to push it the right way, like this. Scores! Casey Middlestad with that shot. Blasted by Dostal in Buffalo. Regains the lead in Anaheim. It's 4-3. That was an adventurous 20 minutes. Sabres from right to left here in the third. And boy, did they need to win this period. Now Alex Tuch out of the penalty box. Walks and scores! Alex Tuch out of the box and parks it in the back of the net. And the Sabres, after the penalty kill, does its job. Take a two-goal lead at 5-3. From the sin bin to a scorer's grin for number 89. And Buffalo needed that one, to say the least. Alex Tuch's 25th of the year to put Buffalo up 5-3. One more here would be the real cushion. Drops it back for Quinn. Quinn looking for Gergensen. Scores with a rocket top shelf. Zemgus Gergensen's with the goal, is 6th of the year. And the Sabres 6th of this game to take a 6-3 lead.
The Sabres snapped their three-game losing skid with a dominant 7-3 win over the Ducks. Only four players did not find the score sheet for Buffalo in this one. Casey Middlestad gets a goal and a helper to extend his point streak to three straight games. Plus, Tyson Jost gets his first multi-point game of the season. Afterwards, Peyton Krebs spoke about Middlestad's contributions.
I think there's tight support. They make plays all around the ice. You know, when you give them the puck, they're going to make some plays. And I just tried to make sure I was hard defensively, so get them the puck, and they did their thing.
Aside from the 7 minutes in the second, you guys feel like you got back to that attacking, aggressive, sort of fearless, you know, approach that you like to have?
Yeah, I think, you know, they had the Crudo's done that a couple good shifts there, kind of hemmed us in, but we stuck to our guns, our system that Donnie puts in place. And that was fun, you know. A little challenge for us, and we made it happen.
Well, as one of the highest scoring teams in the league, it makes sense as to why they put up 7 goals against the Ducks. It was the 4th time they've tallied at least 7 in a game this season. And compared to last season, the Sabres, they didn't even score 7 times in a game at all. Well, in the Eastern Conference, we have the Maple Leafs leapfrog the Lightning in the Atlantic. The Rangers stay at 3rd in the Metro, but are just 3 points back of the Devils. And the Sabres and Red Wings are deadlocked at 58 points, just waiting there in the weeds. Well, it's a battle for 3rd between the Avs and the Wild. And by the looks of it, oh man, they are going to leave it all out on the ice. Stick with us to find out who came out on top next. This battle for the Central features the two teams tied for 3rd place, the Colorado Avalanche and the Minnesota Wild. Both of these teams have struggled scoring lately, but the NHL ranks for their 5-on-5 goals and power play percentage are almost exactly the same. So what's the deal with these two squads? Well, the defending champs, they have cooled a bit after a 6-game win streak, but with Minnesota, it really is wild how they're staying in it, as we can't quite figure them out just yet. Since the new year, Minnesota has scored a league-worst 21 5-on-5 goals in 17 games. They seem to prefer 3-on-3 or even 1-on-1 because all 3 of their wins over the last 10 games have come by way of OT or a shootout. They try for their first regulation win in nearly a month hosting the Avs, and this one was physical.
Tonight in St. Paul from Xcel Energy Center, the defending Stanley Cup champion Colorado Avalanche and the Minnesota Wild. Big game for both teams, Eddie. Tied in the standings, and the Wild had an early power play.
Yeah, you got to be happy with generating the opportunities they had. Jonesy, they got a great chance off the post on that first power play.
Yeah, quite the setup by Kaprizov, guys. He did an outstanding job of elevating that pass on the back end. Erickson X got the shot. He rings it off the pipe. The Wild's best chance of the game so far.
They can play the down and dirty game, Jonesy. They're getting good goaltending. Oh, what a save there. What a save.
That was tipped by Boldy. Now he wants to fight.
And Byram took a shot at him after he redirected it.
They dropped the gloves. Matt Boldy and Bowen Byram. Guys, the pregame show, man. So these teams have had some bad work over the last couple of years.
Boldy redirects this shot at the net. Georgiev with a tremendous save. And then after this, watch if Byram makes contact right here. That's what Boldy did not like.
Both guys willing to go at it. I think we might see a little more of that. Things start to heat up here a little bit in Minnesota.
Really like how that guy's playing. Georgiev, Kenny, they really do.
They sure do. Career high in starts. Play starts. He Kepler's the number one goaltender. And the Avalanche take a 1-0 lead. Andrew Cogliano beating Marc-Andre Fleury.
Yeah, what a well-placed shot. Just underneath the glove and above the pad. Cogliano uses those legs to get some open space and then fires a good shot to give the Avalanche the opening goal.
He's proved himself pretty potent offensive player. So, you know, that's kind of the
Avalanche of the thing. Take a 2-0 lead early in period two. Second goal in as many nights for Dennis Malkin.
Not sure if this puck changes direction or not.
That's kind of what Billy was talking about earlier with Eriksson Ek. Just shoot the puck, right? You don't know what's going to happen. And Malkin now has the hot hand. Goals in back-to-back games after picking up his first in an Avalanche uniform last night.
Boldy with the puck. Spinning on Manson. Back out for Zuccarello. Zuccarello with a wrist shot. They score! Deflected in front. The Wild are on the board. It's now 2-1 Colorado. Eriksson Ek got a piece of it.
Pretty skillful tip. And that traffic's been there for the Wild and finally pays some dividends.
Pass up the middle. Deflected along by Lekkinen. Score! 3-1 Colorado. McKinnon beats Fleury.
How about the speed of Nathan McKinnon? Beautiful play here. He gets a step on Middleton, and then he goes 5-hole on the Flower.
So much deception in the way he handles the puck, Ed. So it's amazing. He gets Flower to open up that 5-hole, knew exactly what he wanted to do with it.
Now to Spurgeon, and now Brodin. Zuccarello. Kaprizov scores!
You can see all the work and emotion that creates that opportunity, and Kaprizov sets patience with the puck after Zuccarello finds him on the backhand, spins and gets it past a couple of legs and elevates it over the glove hand.
And Kaprizov does what he does. The Wild are only down one.
Eriksson Ek and McKinnon. McKinnon wins the draw. Boldy to the puck, and that will do it. The Avalanche hang on and defeat the Minnesota Wild by the score of 3-2. 41 saves for Alexander Georgiev.
The Avs hold on to get the 3-2 win over the Wild to remain in the third-place spot in the Central. Nathan McKinnon records a goal and an assist, earning his third straight multi-point game. Plus, Josh Manson gets a helper in his first game back in the lineup since December 1st. And since the turn of the new year, Nathan McKinnon has shown why he's one of the best players in the league. In 18 games, he has 10 goals and 18 assists for 28 points, trailing only Matthew Tkachuk's 32 for the league lead in that span. Now over to Edmonton as the Oilers host the Red Wings.
Red Wings 19th on the power play, 4 for 12 the past three games. They leave that to the defenders. Comes in down low. Scores! A wraparound goal! Dylan Larkin.
Brilliant feed, and Dylan Larkin continues to light it up. That's his sixth goal in the last 10 periods.
Off the draw, here's Sider.
A backhander that banked in! Campbell never saw it, and how about that for a new twig? A little magic in it, finding its way in by an eyelash. 2-0 Detroit on Sider's fourth.
The Wings have been really good with their sticks. Any cross passes across seem to be get nicked up a little bit and don't make their target.
Wrist shot score, Nugent Hopkins, set up by McDavid. Edmonton right back in the game on Nugent Hopkins, 25th.
Big goal for Edmonton here in the second period, Jack. Sharp angle shot by Ryan Nugent Hopkins. A little Messier-like. And across now, Braun Larkin tried to feed one back to Fabry, knocked away. Outstretched stick kept alive there by Hironic. Here goes back for Fabry. Took a shot, scores! Ronnie Fabry!
Absolutely, if the Wings want to continue their winning ways, especially when you're on the road, your power play has got to be good. And they're making good on these chances. The puck movement, just outstanding.
Swept one back to the line.
What a tip and a save! For his second of the period, and draw Edmonton within 3-2.
Off the draw for Matta, scores! Another face-off win and another goal. Two goals have come tonight on face-off wins. Olli Matta!
perfectly lined up for Mata just to walk into this. So this is almost like the hardest shot at the All-Star game.
Wings, you got to be good defensively. You're going to give up some chances, and when called upon, Huso's going to have to be there.
Now Nugent Hopkins delivers to Barry. One-timer! Drives and scores! Edmonton right back in this game. It's 4-3 on Drysdale's 31st.
Right from the dot. Love to shoot that puck.
Puljujärvi to Ryan. Trying to sneak an interior pass inside. Boston right back on him. You're right, Louis. His best game in weeks. Oh, John redirected. Derek Ryan the tip. And this game is tied.
And they go to work in the offensive zone. This is where they have to excel. They have to win these battles.
McLeod, Janmark, and Holloway the line out. Larkin sprints toward the net. Centers watch out. Magnificent save. Jack Campbell on Bertuzzi. Centering pass. Tremendous third period.
Unbelievable, Jack.
Why not? What a beauty. Four all, final 20 seconds of overtime. In front, there's point blank between the wickets. Couldn't get a shot away. And here's a lead pass. Detroit at the gun. Rasmussen on net. Poke check by Jack Campbell. What a hockey game this has turned out to be. 2 seconds. Drysdale centers. Tipped away from McDavid. At the horn. 4-4 through 65. In on Huso. Plenty of speed. Shoots and denied. He can give the Wings the win. Campbell to force another round. Backhander score. Hughes Suter gives Detroit victory, and the Red Wings outlast the Oilers 5-4 in a magnificent hockey game.
The Red Wings with a huge 2 points in Edmonton.
Awesome game. Those Red Wings are hot. The 5-4 shootout win against the Oilers on Wednesday is the team's fourth victory in a row. Robbie Fabbri now has 5 points in the last two contests as he records his second consecutive multi-point game. Plus, Mo Sider's goal extends his point streak to 5 games. Here's Pugh Suter on the shootout win.
One of those nights, highly entertaining. Were you able to kind of enjoy it, especially, I guess, with the way it ended in a victory for your team?
Yeah, for sure. I think being up 2 goals, going to third, and they tied up, and we still come off with the win. That's a great character win for our team.
It was a long shootout, so you're on the bench watching, waiting, and then you get your opportunity. What's kind of going through your mind in regards to what you want to try and do to beat Jack Campbell?
I usually when Larks did his move, I saw something, and then I just like, if I get to go, that's my move, and worked out well.
Yes, it did. All right, well, Dylan Larkin has been on fire since the All-Star break. In 5 games, he has 6 goals for 9 points and is shooting over 31%. As we get closer to the trade deadline on March 3rd, will teams be looking at adding Larkin, or will the Red Wings hold on to him for a late playoff push? Something to keep our eye on. And in the Western Conference, the Avs gain ground in the Central Division and pull ahead of the Wild. Speaking of the Wild, their loss to the Avs drops them out of the second wildcard spot in favor of the Calgary Flames. Well, we are just a few days away from the Stadium Series between the Capitals and Hurricanes on Saturday. When we come back, we'll catch up with Dylan Strome as he gets ready for that Carolina matchup.
Matthews, his shot, he scores! Austin Matthews in his first game back. That's a beauty! Matthews back and back on the board.
On his stick and off the stick in just seconds and up and under the bar.
Zibanejad with room, he moves in, he shoots, he scores! Mika Zibanejad, another beauty!
Fake, and Zibanejad beats him quickly through the legs.
What a roll Mika Zibanejad is on. Goals in 5 straight games.
Score! Colorado McKinnon beats Fleury.
I'm up to speed of Nathan McKinnon. Beautiful play here. McKinnon gets it in perfect stride. He gets a step on Middleton, and he goes 5-hole on the flower. Such a fear factor for any goaltender when he's coming down the ice. Thompson scores!
Tage Thompson unleashes the TNT
from his house there at the left circle, 98.6 miles per hour.
And he set up right on his dot over there where he likes to be, and he's able to unload on it.
On Elliott to the front, he scores! Oh, is that greasy?
How about that for Shelf?
It stopped, but he got it in. Coyotes win, shootout winner in the desert.
Connor Ingram, in my mind, first, second, and third stop. Give it to him, look at the love he's getting.
Wrist shot score, Nugent Hopkins, set up by McDavid.
And a little drop pass by McDavid, and boom, far side.
What a tip and a save. Rebound score!
Beautiful backhand pass by Connor McDavid.
We know Connor McDavid is great, but I mean, he's great wherever he plays, whether he's on home ice or on the road. You're getting the same thing. Lots and lots of points. Sitting at 99 points this season, he is just 1 point shy of his sixth 100-point season of his career. The 2023 Navy Federal Credit Union NHL Stadium Series is quickly approaching, with the Caps and Canes set to square off Saturday at 8 p.m. Eastern. As you can see, preparations are coming along nicely at NC State's Carter-Finley Stadium. Now, you might be wondering, how will the NHL pull off ice in sunny North Carolina? Good news, the current forecast for Saturday night is cloudy with temperatures in the low 40s. So it sounds like perfect hockey weather. And we will have you covered for pregame live from Raleigh right here on NHL Network starting at 7 p.m. Eastern. And then ABC and ESPN Plus will have the matchup between the Capitals and Hurricanes at 8 o'clock. The Caps' own Dylan Strome joined the crew on NHL Now earlier on Wednesday to talk about the team's big outdoor event.
I want to welcome in Dylan Strome. Dude, we appreciate you hopping on with us. And, you know, it's great news to see when that went down. I just got to say this, though. You guys couldn't squeeze Brian McClellan for a little bit more to get more. You got the same contract as your brother. Like, you don't even get bragging rights out of this, man.
Another dollar. Another dollar.
Just a dollar more.
I know. I didn't want to be, you know, greedy. I think that's, you know, a lot of money, and very happy to be able to sign that. And I'll take it that I'm 4 years younger. How about that?
There you go, you get a little more earning power longer.
But adjusted for age, you're right. Yes. You're in a much better spot. Yes. I hadn't thought of that. Yeah. That's a good point.
No, but congrats to both of you guys. But I just want to say this to you before we get off the top here. Back in that draft, third overall, Connor, you got Jack Eichel, yourself. And I ran into you in Erie, and when you got sent back, and you're going through a little bit of a grind there, just trying to make sense of everything. It's a tough thing to go through. And I just love the progression of your career, and you've earned every cent of this, and I can't wait to see what the future holds. But can you take us through some of those moments that you had to push through that's gotten you here?
Yeah, of course. I think not everyone's path is a straight shot to the NHL. Obviously going back to Erie after my first year when I got drafted, everyone was saying I had a great camp and everyone was happy with what I had done. And then play on the World Junior team and have a pretty good junior year, and team goes pretty far in the playoffs. And then you go back next year and you make the team out of camp, so you think things are good. And then you're in a lineup and you play a couple games and it doesn't work out, and you go back and kind of the narrative starts to change a little bit. So it took a little while to break those narratives of, you know, not being able to be a consistent NHL player. And like I said at the beginning, not everyone has a straight path to the NHL. And mine's been a little bit different. And, I'm thankful for all the steps I had to take to get there, you know, playing a full season in the AHL and playing two extra years of junior and getting to play the World Juniors twice. So I think, everything led up to the point where the Capitals wanted to sign me on July 13th and then, or July 14th. And then, luckily, turning that into five more years. So very thankful that, for all the steps I took and now here I am.
Yeah, it's a great point, Dylan. There is no perfect path. There's no even preferred path necessarily. And for those of us, because I'm one of those guys that you're describing in terms of your own journey to get there, it doesn't matter what path you take. And in fact, sometimes the non-conventional path, assuming you get to the NHL, it makes you appreciate it all that more. Here you sit, well over 300 games under your belt at this point. You know, everybody comes into it with, you know, their own set of expectations. But what have you learned about life in the NHL today, given your experience? What have you learned about your game? What have you learned about just the environment overall? Because it's different than, your expectation at the front end.
Yeah, for sure. You know, when you're 18 and you get drafted and you go to the team, you know, everyone's very high on you. Everyone's treating you, you know, really well. And then, you know, you get to see how those guys live, how the NHL players live. You know, get to, you know, travel really easily, stay in really nice hotels. You know, we get good meals, we're going out for good dinners on the road and things like that. And, you know, then you get sent down to the AHL and you're, you know, riding the bus for a long time where you're flying on Southwest. And, you know, as a rookie, you're getting a middle seat and, you know, things change pretty quickly. You're not getting your breakfast is cooked for you like we do here. So, you know, I think it takes it into perspective for sure. You know, yeah. I think, you got to work for what you get. And, like you said, Stu, I think, everyone's path is different. And, you know, sometimes you learn to appreciate a little bit more of the smaller things. So I definitely am and very thankful and fortunate that, I've gotten the opportunity to play for this long and hopefully it's a lot longer.
A question for you on maybe just the way the season has gone and looking forward a little bit too, because, you know, out of the gate, the Caps are dealing with a good bit this year. Wilson's out of the mix, Backstrom's out of the mix for a good long while, integrating a new number one netminder. You know, it seems like this group has kind of had to been challenged to refine its identity a little bit. Do you feel like where you're at, are you maybe focused on some fine tuning even at this point? Because it's getting pretty tight in the East, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure. I think, especially with this team, you know, obviously the expectations are really high. Everyone wants to be in the playoffs and make a run. You know, with the team we have, I think we're the oldest average age in the NHL with, I think, somewhere in like 30.5 or something like that as average age. So I think everyone knows and everyone understands that, you know, we need to kind of dial it in down the stretch here. But like you said, yeah, we kind of started off not great. We lost our first two games. We won a couple, the next two with some big comebacks, but like you see there on the standings, everything's getting pretty tight, and it's you know, every game matters. So you know, we lost the Hurricanes last night in the close game, and you know, we play the Panthers tomorrow, so those teams are right there. Then we play the Hurricanes again on Saturday in the Stadium Series. So every game's huge coming down the stretch, and you know, I really believe in the team that we have. I think you're right. Like, we are still fine tuning some things, but when we play in a certain way, I think we're a pretty tough team to beat, and we proved that in December, and hopefully we can find that coming down the stretch here.
You just mentioned the Stadium Series coming up this weekend on Saturday. You played in the 2019 Winter Classic. So you have outdoor playing experience. What are you looking forward to this weekend? Is your team getting dialed up? Any extra tricks, you know, uniform-wise, or any adjustments you've made?
We got full new gear. We got new gloves, helmets, pants, and obviously jerseys. So it's gonna be exciting. You can see there, the one thing I noticed when I was playing the first time, you know, in a regular hockey rink, the people are right on top of you. Like, there's no room from the glass to the seats. There's like literally 1 foot probably. But in this, you know, there's, I don't know, 40, 50 yards from where people are, however far that is. And I noticed that when I was playing in Notre Dame that, you know, people are further away than you think, and there's a little bit more time out there. You know, it's kind of an open game. It's different for sure, but I think everyone's excited. I'm just looking there. I had some good chances in that game. Didn't get any, but oh, I missed that one. Good juice.
Yep. Oh.
Great stuff. Time now to go Top Shelf.
Puck is down underway here in Toronto, and it's William Nylander right to the net, and he scores! 9 seconds!
A little button hook right through the middle of the ice, and thanks for coming.
What a start for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Comes in down low, scores! A wraparound goal! Dylan Larkin, is he ever on a roll? Hagel with a burst of speed. Hagel, a little drop, Stamkos! He can't put it home! Oh, what a stop! Connor Ingram again!
Here's Hagel. Dancing in, Stamkos gets the puck and just can't tuck it in.
Zibanejad with room, he moves in, he shoots, he scores! Mika Zibanejad, another beauty! With a goal in his fifth consecutive game.
Trailer Shattenkirk right down Main Street. Comrie leaves it later out and they score! Cam Fowler's second of the game! And there it is, Eric Comrie leaving some loose change. Cam Fowler just sneaks down from that point, and it's a gimme. Quinn looking for Gergensen, scores with a rocket Top Shelf. Zegras Gergensen's with the goal.
Yeah, this line's looked good all night long. Coach has done a nice job here centering these two guys.
Big shot score, Nugent Hopkins set up by McDavid. Hyman took the hit to make it play.
This is a sharp angle shot by Ryan Nugent Hopkins.
So many people around the hockey world have a lot of respect for Wayne Simmons for a variety of reasons. It starts with the way he plays.
Simmons in a goal! He scores! Wayne Simmons!
is a guy who's not exactly built like Eric Lindros, but when he looks in the mirror, that's what he sees.
And Simmons got in behind the defense, scores! David Camp follows up.
He's a tall, thin guy, but he plays incredibly tough. We know he can fight. He's fearless. He sticks up for his teammates. So when you talk to the guys in the Leafs, the young guys, you talk to Austin Matthews, you talk to Will Smarter, they look up to Wayne Simmons because he's a guy worth looking up to.
If you're a young hockey player, Wayne Simmons is definitely someone to admire. With over 1,000 games and 500 points in the NHL, Wayne has spent his time with six different clubs, amassing 15 seasons in the National Hockey League. He was the 2017 All-Star Game MVP and winner of the Mark Messier Leadership Award in the 2018-19 season. It is time now for the three stars of the night. Our third star is Willie Nylander. Nylander recorded a goal and two assists in the Leafs' 5-2 win over the Blackhawks and earned his sixth three-point game of the season. Our second star is Artemi Panarin, who scored twice in the Rangers' 6-4 victory over the Canucks on Wednesday. Panarin now has six goals and two helpers in his last two games. And, of course, our first star of the night is Connor Ingram, who earned his first career shutout in the Coyotes' 1-0 shootout win over the Lightning. Ingram stopped all 47 shots to get the victory. Here he is after the win.
Pissed off. He did the exact same thing last night, so I knew it was coming. And I thought I got a lot of it, but just ended up going up and over me. But luckily we got two and held down the only one, so we'll take it.
And Connor, you've been playing unbelievably well this last month and a half, but haven't been able to get the wins. How sweet is this one?
Yeah, exactly. Come close a couple times in a row there. You start to get a little frustrated, so to pull one out feels good. I mean, I thought all of us, that's a good hockey team to play against. And, you know, we stuck with it. We hung in there the whole time and eventually got it done in the end.
And now for the latest edition of Walk This. We take you to Atlanta and check this out. This is Ryder Matz of the Atlanta Mad Hatters. What a move. A ridiculous lacrosse style goal. No, not the Michigan, because that was on the rush. An incredible move. In fact, it made its way to the NHL's Fan Skills at homepage. Remember, if you think you've got a move that can compete with Ryder's, just add hashtag NHL Fan Skills to your social media post. And maybe it'll be right here on the Fly. That does it for all of us. I'm Erica Wachter. Now the best from Wednesday night. Enjoy it.
At Mullet Arena, where it is Star Wars night.
Score! How about the speed of Nathan MacKinnon?
Austin Matthews back and back on the board.
And Artemi Panarin continues red hot.
Tage Thompson unleashes the TNT, 98.6 miles per hour.
The Red Wings with a huge